Junji Ito has already etched himself into a manga legend. For horror, it's hard to look beyond Ito for sheer terrifying brilliance. His deeply disturbing but macabre style has been entertaining fans, if not scaring the life out of them, for decades now. With classics such as Uzumaki and before that Tomie, Ito capitalized on the huge manga horror boom of the late 90s to become well known globally. Countless movie adaptations have also helped with the success, but it's the original artwork that will forever confirm Junji Ito's legacy. What we're gonna do today is look through Ito's work, his life, and his career-defining works. That's, of course, if you're not too scared to keep watching. Ito didn't have the most orthodox path to becoming a manga horror pioneer. He was actually trained as a dental technician and juggled an inspiring art hobby with his career. But his interest in artwork goes back way further than that. Junji Ito was born in 1963 in the Gifu Prefecture. It was his two older sisters that were a bad or good influence depending on your point of view. They would read works from fellow horror legends Kazuo Umizu and Shinichi Koga in magazines. He started reading them too, and this started what was to become a lifelong fascination with horror. He did this while growing up in the countryside, in a small city named Nakasugawa, near Nagano. In his house, the bathroom was at the end of an underground tunnel, where there were spider crickets which would become inspiration for later works. This would start a trend for Ito to take his life experiences into his work, albeit in a massively more horrific ways than the source material. Ito started working as a dental technician after graduating in his early 20s. This is when he really started to put pen or pencil to paper and started producing his now trademark style. In 1987, a short story of his featured in Halloween, a monthly magazine, and won an honorable mention in the Kazuo Umizu Prize. The story was eventually serialized into what is now known as Tomie. The story was inspired by the sudden death of Ito's classmate. He has said that he expected the boy to reappear as if nothing happened, which is exactly what happens to the Tomie herself in the Tomie stories. Of course, in true Ito style, it's not the only thing that happens. He also added his signature mix of horrific themes into the tale. Tomie was Ito's first showcasing of some themes that would recur throughout his work, beauty being the most significant. Tomie is an impossibly beautiful character, and she uses this beauty to manipulate her victims to their deaths. She does this in a variety of ways, which includes jealous rage, suicide, and being driven to madness, which I don't blame her. Because of this, she has the same traits of a succubus, in a way, a demon that seduces men only to take life from them. Not only does she go out to kill those which she manages to make fall in love with her, but she also goes out to kill herself. Not in a suicidal way, but the fact that she's able to clone herself, meaning that she has duplicates. The new Tomie goes out to destroy the previous versions by burning them to leave no trace of which to regenerate from. It's worth noting that Tomie never kills by her own hand. She always gets the men that she has seduced to do her dirty work for her, emphasizing her powers of manipulation. Tomie marked the start of Ito's career and his legacy. From then, he'd be prolific in producing works of horror. Ito himself has said that his main influences, away from his own personal experiences, have come from Kazuo Umizu, which, as we've already said, he read with his sisters as a child, as well as Hideshi Hino, Koga Shinsaku, Yasutaka Tsutsui, and H.P. Lovecraft. With a combination of these legendary writers behind him, as well as Ito's own eye for finding the horror in every day, his works show a pattern of themes. This includes body horror, seemingly ordinary characters who begin to act out of irrational compulsion, the breakdown of society, deep sea organisms, and the inevitability of one's demise. Needless to say that you probably shouldn't read Ito if you're looking for something light. The themes of deep sea organisms and societal collapse brings us on to Ito's next important work. Uzumaki was pitched more for an adult men in contrast with Tomie that appealed more to a younger demographic. This quote-unquote seinen manga was featured in the weekly manga magazine Big Comic Spirits, Comics and ran from 1998 to 1999. During the same period, publisher Shogakukan, or Shogakukan, released a series based on Uzumaki, published in three volumes. Uzumaki follows a high school teenager, Kiri Egoshima, her boyfriend Shuichi Saito, and the citizens of a small, fictional Japanese town of Kurozocho. The coastal town starts to become cursed, but not by a person or ghost, but spirals. The story of Uzumaki originated when Ito tried to write a story about people living in a very long terraced house, and he was inspired to use a spiral shape to get the length that he wanted. The row houses become pivotal to the story, as they are the last remaining structures left after a storm destroys much of the town. As the story continues, as the curse takes hold on the town, and the spirals become the center point of everyone's lives, Kirie herself gets taken over by them, and her hair begins to curl into an unnatural spiral pattern, drains her life energy to hypnotize the citizens, and chokes her whenever she attempts to cut it off. She eventually does, which shaves her, with the help of Saito, but the rest of the town aren't so lucky. The theme of societal breakdown is all over Uzumaki, as well as a force that's beyond the characters, which is where the real horror takes hold. Ito himself believes the horror of Uzumaki is effective due to its subversion of symbols, which are positively portrayed in Japanese media, and its themes of the main characters struggling against a mysterious force stronger than themselves. This sense of random demise for no apparent reason would be ever present in the rest of Ito's works. These are Ito's most well-known and epic works, but there are plenty of other stories that he's told over the years, all of which hold true to the sense of bizarre things overwhelming the completely normal, like with Gyo. Gyo takes undead fish, fuses them with metal legs to create this death stench that takes over a community. This story walks a fine line between the completely absurd and the horrific, creating a nasty sense of the uncanny. Without Ito's trademark style, a story like this could have just come across as purely funny. There are also other tales that go back to focusing on beauty and the curse that this puts on people. The short fashion model story details a monstrous model with razor-sharp teeth that Ito was inspired to write by the Halloween magazine that originally published his first works. He saw a genuine model and thought her smile was monstrous, so he literally worked that into one of his later stories, where this monstrous mouth posing as beautiful literally rips through another model and a film crew. On the subject of beauty, and particularly hair, which we've looked at in both Tomie and Uzumaki, there are plenty of other examples of Ito's obsession here. In this portfolio, we see a girl's hair rebelling against being cut off and runs off with her head, girls deliberately catching a disease that makes them beautiful, but then makes them murder each other, as well as a woman treating her skin with lotion so she could take it off and look at her muscles, but the skin dissolves and she tries to steal her sister's instead. This constant juxtaposition of beauty and horror is never far away with Ito, and he's not the first to have used it, but there are plenty of warnings here of the fine line that people in general are always treading when it comes to narcissism. Junji Ito is a legendary manga artist and a true giant of the horror genre, using inspiration from those before him across different art forms, as well as finding the scariness in a seemingly tedious world. He paints a sense of ease in his work that few others can pull off. Junji Ito's legacy is already cemented after an over 30-year career, and it's far from being done yet. A recent commission of a Toonami version of Uzumaki is testament to that, and will open up his classic chilling stories to a whole new world of tortured fans. Hopefully, you're already one of them. And if not, have fun going through his back catalog, as well as being terrified in the process.